Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to You Should Play. Now today, we're looking at an actual masterpiece of a game. A game that literally defined and refined the entire landscape of video games across the board. You would not have the myriad of titles that you have today if it were not for Half-Life. So today, on You Should Play, we're going to be taking a look at the original 1998 release of Half-Life. This is not the source port of Half-Life, this is the OG. And the description reads, named Game of the Year by over 50 publications, Valve's debut title blends action and adventure with award-winning technology to create a frighteningly realistic world where players must think to survive. It also includes an exciting multiplayer mode that allows you to play against friends and enemies around the world. The developer and publisher is Valve Software. It is on Steam for $9.99. Now, this is an absolute blast for the past for me. I've had a lot of people come to me and say, hey, Alex, why do you do games that were older, that people didn't get to play back then, that are highly recommended by the PC community? And this is one of them. So with every You Should Play, let's take a look at the options menu. Now, if you were back in the day on Steam like I was, this menu, this color scheme is so nostalgic. It brings back more than you could ever ask for. So we've got full keyboard bindings across the board, full mouse control, which is even better, raw mouse input as well. We're going to click that, no joystick. No auto aim, we don't need that. No mouse filter, mouse look. That's how old this is. Is there going to be mouse look? Yes or no? Audio will keep the same. Look at that MP3 volume. Can't get any better. This game actually has resolution beyond 4K for a 1998 PC port. Think about that. When we talk about graphical settings and what is available to games, a game from 1998 has support for 5120 by 2880. That should be the standard across the board. Having the ability to go through and really just provide support for multiple resolutions across the gamut. Not only does it have widescreen, it also has 4x3, or what they would be considered normal. This was back in 1998 when there wasn't a standard. You don't have that anymore today. It's ridiculous. But even then, the visuals are not where they need to be in terms of graphical options. The source port does add more of those things to it, but the source port is a bit buggy across the board. So if you're going to play this for the first time, I suggest the original 1998 release. It even has online. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare for Half-Life.
Good morning, and welcome to the Black Mesa Transit System. This automated train is provided for the security and convenience of the Black Mesa Research Facility personnel. The time is 8:47 a.m. Current topside temperature is 93 degrees, with an estimated high of 105. The Black Mesa compound is maintained at a pleasant 68 degrees at all times. This train is inbound from Level 3 dormitories to Sector C test labs and control facilities. If your intended destination is a high security area beyond Sector C, you will need to return to the central transit hub in Area 9 and board a high security train. If you have not yet submitted your identity to the retinal clearance system, you must report to Black Mesa personnel for processing before you will be permitted into the high security branch of the transit system. Material routinely handled in the Black Mesa compound, No smoking, eating, or drinking are permitted within the Black Mesa Transit System. Please keep your limbs inside the train at all times. Do not attempt to open the doors until the train has come to a complete halt at the station platform. In the event of an emergency, passengers are to remain seated and await further instruction. If it is necessary to exit the train, disabled personnel should be evacuated first. Please stay away from electrified rails and proceed to an emergency station until assistance arrives. Mesa Hazard Course Decathlon will commence this evening at 1900 hours in the Level 3 facility. The semifinals for high security personnel will be announced in a separate secure access transmission. Remember, more lives than your own may depend on your fitness. Do you have a friend or relative who would make a valuable addition to the Black Mesa team? Immediate openings are available in the areas of materials handling and low clearance security. Please contact Black Mesa personnel for further information. If you have an associate with a background in the areas of theoretical physics, biotechnology, or other high-tech disciplines, please contact our civilian recruitment division. The Black Mesa Research Facility is an opportunity.
If you've ever played Bioshock, the entire introduction of Bioshock is pulled from this game. It's unbelievable how much Half-Life is so important to the industry and games completely across the board.
Missing a scheduled urinalysis or radiation checkup.
Look at this.
For immediate termination. If you feel
Look
you have been
is.
Exposed to radioactive or other hazardous materials in the course of your duties, contact your radiation safety officer immediately. Work safe. Work smart. Your future depends on it.
It's so smart how they give you information
now
about Gordon.
Sector C test labs and control facilities.
There's Barry. So what they did was providing you who you're playing as, his name, up front and center.
Please stand back from the automated door and wait for the security officer to verify your identity. Before exiting the train, be sure to check your area for personal belongings. Thank you, and have a very safe and productive day.
It's so fantastic.
Good morning, Mr. Freeman. Looks like you're running late.
The sound came from his mouth. You saw that? That's so good. But this game did so much in those first few minutes that no game has ever tried to do again or continues to try to do again. Some games got really close, like I said before, like Bioshock, where you went pulled down into Rapture and you got pulled through all of this. But the genius of providing you the information about Gordon Freeman right up front in the center of the screen through his name, his degree, his age, his position, all that backstory you were given, seeing that run through of Black Mesa and just getting an understanding of like, this is some real shit that we're going to be getting into, is such a wild concept to be thrown at you at 1998 of all things. And then to have this game just surpass that and still do even more.
I'm on duty, Mr. Freeman. Hey, catch me later, I'll buy you a beer.
Here, We're in anomalous materials now.
It's good to see you.
Hey, Mr. Freeman. I had a bunch of messages for you, but we had a system crash about 20 minutes ago, and I'm still trying to find my files. Just one of those days, I guess. They were having some problems down in the test chamber, too, but I think that's all straightened out. They told me to make sure you headed down there as soon as you got into your hazard suit.
We're going to the hazard suit, boys.
Please, leave me alone until after the experiment. You'll just have to wait until after the test.
And look how smart, like, so they gave you the map of the area, right? But then they designed the actual level design with this in mind. So we have to go down to anomalous materials. And the easiest way to just follow it is, look. Anomalous materials, labs, personal facilities. So we've got to get our bio suit first, right? Or our HEV suit, excuse me.
Hello there. Freeman?
So you can just follow the lines. What we're gonna do though is cook a burrito. Oh, is it gonna mess up on him? Sure does.
This is all within theoretical limits.
Look at that. I got it for you. Come on, do it. Do the thing.
Excuse me, Gordon, but I'm rather busy now.
My God!
Yeah.
What are you doing?
There it is. Look at that. 1998, baby. All right, let's go.
As I expected.
Different sounding floors, like...
Greetings!
Sorry, sir. I've got to stay at my post.
Retinal scan.
Freeman, I got explicit orders not to let you through without your hazard suit on.
Let's get our hazard suit.
I hope those containment parameters are still nominal. Ah, hello, Gordon Freeman. It's good to see you. Most of us. Why do we all have...
There it is. Full suit, but no helmet.
Welcome to the HEV Mark IV protective system. For use in hazardous environment conditions. High impact reactive armor activated.
Yeah.
Atmospheric contaminant sensors activated. Vital sign monitoring activated.
Protective right on through, sir. Looks like you're in the barrel today.
Weapon selection system activated. Munition level
activated. Communications interface on. Jamming. There's so much of this game. It's so well designed. Now, if you don't want to, if you're like, oh, I don't want to play these old graphics and stuff like that. Yeah, okay, some people are like that, but you know what? I think the old graphics are charming, and I think they're actually really well done. You could try the Black Mesa mod that was released as a standalone product, so that does work too.
Weren't you supposed to be in the test chamber half an hour ago?
Test lab access control room. Let's do it.
Ah, it's good to see you. Ah, Gordon, here you are. We just sent the sample down to the test chamber.
We've boosted the anti-mass spectrometer to 105%. Bit of a gamble, but we need the extra resolution.
The administrator is very concerned that we get a conclusive analysis of today's sample. I gather they went to some lengths to get it.
They're waiting for you, Gordon, in the test chamber.
The test chamber.
Access denied.
Ooh.
It's about to go critical.
Oh shit. That's not good.
What the hell is going on with our equipment?
It wasn't meant to do this in the first place.
That looks normal. That looks normal. That doesn't look normal. Uh-oh. Head on over to the test lab.
Deviating a bit from standard analysis procedures today, Gordon.
Yes, but with good reason. This is a rare opportunity for us. This is the purest sample we've seen yet.
And, potentially, the most unstable.
Now, if you follow standard insertion procedures, everything will be fine.
I don't know how you can say that, although I will admit that the possibility of a resonance cascade scenario is extremely unlikely.
Gordon doesn't need to hear all this. He's a highly trained professional. We've assured the administrator that nothing will go wrong.
Yes, you're right. Gordon, we have complete confidence in you.
Well, go ahead. Let's let him in now.
Boom. Look at this. Imagine playing this in 1998 and this is what you walked into. With your voodoo graphics card.
Testing? Everything seems to be in order.
All right, Gordon. Your suit should keep you comfortable through all this. The specimen will be delivered to you in a few moments. If you would be so good as to climb up and start the rotors, we can bring the anti-mass spectrometer to 80% and hold it there until the carrier arrives.
Okay. Oh. Uh-oh.
Very good. We'll take it from here.
Power to stage one emitters in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, damn. Give me the thing to push.
Overhead capacitors to 105%. It's probably not a problem. Probably, but I'm showing a small discrepancy in... Well, no, it's well within acceptable bounds again. Sustaining sequence.
I've just been informed that the sample is ready, Gordon. It should be coming up to you any moment. Look to the delivery system. Your specimen.
Okay. Let's push that shit.
Get away from the
shut it down.
No,
oh. Shut it down. It's not shutting down.
Oh.
Thank you.
unforeseen consequences. Oh, everything blew up, and it's all your fault. Look a little head crab. Look a little head crab.
Access denied. Access.
Why didn't they rush? I never thought I'd see a resonance cascade, let alone create one.
Gordon, you're alive. Thank God for that hazard suit. I'm afraid to move him and all our phones are out. Please, get to the surface as soon as you can and let someone know we're stranded down here. You'll need me to activate the retinal scanners. I'm sure the rest of the science team will gladly help you.
Fine. You won't even know I'm here. I predicted all of this, you know. All of it.
Mm-hmm. I bet you did, buddy. Holy shit. Let's crash onto that. Oh! I just took damage. It actually hits you. I had no idea. Huh. Caution laser. Oh, yeah. Oh. Look how this was back in 98, dude. How wild was your mind when all this was going off? That's right. The classic. I bet people got stuck there all the time. Break all the glass. I have 15 health and I'm gonna die. Holy shit. Oh man. Am I gonna quick save on this? I probably am. Let's save so I don't actually die. Oh, it's been saving for me. Okay, cool. Let's see if we go through here. It's closed. Okay, it's open. Everybody's dead. Got some ammo. That's fine. I think from my memories that these guys were actually devs on the game. We can heal up. There we go. About what? About 40 HP is what you get. The great thing about this game is how quiet everything is. And it really gives you that horror sort of like. He took 20 HP off me. Holy jeez. Oh! That would have ended me. You can move everything around. Like, just this... The way... The things this game did were just unbelievable. There we go. No, oh. Can't, oh no! Holy Jesus. Like, this was a horror game. I still think it is a horror game. Oh, oh, wow. And even playing this game back, what, 30 years later? Less than 30? Around there? 98, 2021, yeah. I mean, we're 7 years shy. But, almost 30 years. This game still holds up. It still does things that no other game does.
You're going to have to leave me here.
Let's go a little further, just to give you guys a little bit more of the experience that we got here. What was that? Oh, we got, what, 18 rounds left? That's not bad. Look at those polygons, baby. How great were those back in the day, huh? Uh-oh. Alright, let's see. Move the big lever. Boom. Look at that. That's not a bad M9 model either for a pistol. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, this is the beginning of Half-Life. These head crabs do not want to mess around. But if you're liking what you're seeing, I highly recommend you play what I consider to be an actual masterpiece in a video game. And honestly, it really goes to show why people love games that Valve makes so much. It's just unbelievable what they can do and the way they tell stories and how they do it. It's very ingenious a lot of the time, so I highly recommend you give it a shot and enjoy what is pretty much a solidly crazy horror game that was released almost 30 years ago. But hey, if you like the video and you like the content, subscribe to the channel. It does mean a lot. We have officially broken 6,000 subscribers, and it's mind-boggling to me that this is what we're getting towards, and I just really want everyone to say, I just want everyone to know that I'm very thankful for all of this, to get to do this in my spare time, and it's awesome. So thank you guys for everything, and see you guys in the next video, and more fanboy content coming soon. More Let's see if we can get this guy here. And just daily content and streams, so thanks so much. I know I said that before, but I'm gonna say it again. Have a great one, and enjoy this masterpiece of a video game, because it is phenomenal. See you guys later, and have a great one. Good night.